We are out here and right in the camp. I'm here with Chico. Chico, we got quite a few people that are in need out here, don't
yes,
we?
Yes.
I think this is a part of a family over here.
Yes.
That's in need. Let's talk to a few here. When their truck arrives, by the way, I can do that if you need to help unload this truck. I want to show you folks. We got all kinds of supplies that we're distributing to the camp here. It's because of those of you that are sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center. We've been out shopping. We've gotten them the charcoal. How important are the supplies that we've been bringing you?
They're very important.
You got a lot of people to take care of. How many we got out here right now just at this camp?
My camp, I got 34.
34. And they keep coming nightly, and I gave you a couple of tents. You have people waiting on tents, don't you?
That's right.
All right, and then we have another camp down the way, and then they're starting another one across the street here. And
yes.
We got a whole bunch of them popping up.
Yeah, they're popping up. Right. Now, right. That's right.
A lot of people in need, and a lot of folks here. How are you guys doing? I heard somebody stole your van.
Yeah, they stole his mom's van.
Somebody stole your mom's van? Wow, so you don't have a van now.
Mm-mm.
And you're out here with the rest of them needing a place to sleep. Is that it? What is it? You, your mom,
and brother.
Uh-huh.
And my other brother and sister.
Oh, and they're all without a place right now.
They all over there.
Yeah. We trying to get a shelter right now.
All right, there's no room in shelters right now, folks. That's why the people are all out here. There's no room in the shelters. I mean, we need to try to help people. They're hurting out here. We're out here trying to get some help to the people that are in need. How are y'all today? I think he's got some sandwiches up there if you're hungry, and they got juice cups and all kinds of things. Okay. Yes, we're out here trying to help the people that are out and right now. There are more and more tents coming up here. This is one of, come to mind, let's see, one, two, three, about four, five different places. We're going to be going around to some of these. There's a lot of urgent needs among the people. They today wanted to ice out here. They wanted barbecue sauce, or chicken. Yeah, they got the barbecue sauce, the chicken. We got to have a barbecue. We got ice and juice cups and all different kinds of things. And if you notice, right behind us here is City Hall, right in the mayor's window. She doesn't want this because she can't deny the homeless are out here. She can't deny this because they're right on her window. And this is the first camp. Go down the road here, you got another camp. And we have another one behind the Murphy building over there. One behind the old Greyhound bus station, and then vacant buildings that people in, and then many up and down the riverfront, 75, 80, 100 people along there. So just so many, many people out here that are in need at this particular time. So this camp's been here for a few weeks. They wanted to shut it down in the middle of the night. The CDC said that they do that, they're just going to scatter the homeless all over, and those that are suffering from the coronavirus are going to be just spreading it. And they're out here. I've been in the woods. I think it's yesterday and in Springfield and then here, trying to get the emergency supplies out to the people here. They're always in need of ice out here, particularly in this hot weather. Ice out here and different other items. Okay. And how are you guys? Got it all set up here? Everything going over here? And bring the ice. How are you today, sister? Yeah, it looked like you guys may have a barbecue. We're bringing you some chicken, barbecue sauce, and the rest.
Really? Yeah. Nice. Thank you so much.
Yeah, so you're staying out here in a tent.
Yep.
How are you?
Hey, Larry. How you doing?
Oh, people say, why are y'all out here? It's hard to find a place to live, isn't it?
Yes, it is, Larry. They want first and last.
Yeah.
And if you ain't got it, you out of there.
69% of Americans weren't able to pay their rent. I mean, 26,500,000 plus unemployment. I mean, there may be a lot of people out here.
Oh, yeah. They try to act like it's going to get better, but I don't see it, Larry.
Well, even if that coronavirus, I pray, goes away, you still got some real economic problems.
Oh, yeah. All over the country. All over. Yeah. Not just St. Louis. All over the country. Yeah.
Well, folks, again, God bless you. Good talking to you. And we got quite a few out here. We're going to continue to go from place to place. Some are waiting on clothes. I think of one stop we got to make. The guy hadn't been able to change clothes for 2 weeks. Wow, if we had 1411 Locust open, we could. They could all be coming in for showers right now. The bathrooms, a place for them to go during the day. A lot of people in need. And I'm asking all of you to keep us in your prayers here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. Hi, how are you today? Anything in particular you need?
Like underclothes, really? I had got some hygiene products.
Yeah,
it's just like more like the underclothes
okay.
part.
Our women And let me see what they can get together by Friday morning, okay?
All right, thank you so much.
What's your name?
My name is Renata Frank.
Hi, Renata. Somebody say, why are you in their tent, Renata?
Oh, just the job, the corona hit my job.
What job did you have?
I was working at a temp service in Cahokia, Illinois. It was called Higher Level, and my boyfriend didn't think it was safe for me to return. I was scared, and the fear kind of got to me, and then later on, the corona did hit the job and stuff. So I'm a working girl. This is new to me, you know, but you definitely get food.
Well, maybe we can get our safe house open. Maybe we can get you into one of our safe houses when you talk. I'll have Linda and them come talk to you Friday morning.
Okay, yes, I'll be here Friday morning.
All right, I'm talking to her and many others, and I'm asking all of you to keep us in your prayers here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. A lot of people in need, and we need all of you at this time. It looks like we have a lot of folks over here trying to get help, gathering around our coolers for sandwiches and other emergency supplies, and we need all of you to please be there with us. How are you today, sir? Good. You making it okay?
Yes, sir.
You got your tent?
Sir.
You got a tent out here?
Yes, sir.
Oh, that's your tent?
Yes,
that's
sir.
That's your home?
Yes, sir.
Well, it's better to have that than just to wander the streets all night, isn't it?
Yes, sir, it is.
Well, let's pray that they let you stay here and not run you off, okay? Because, you know, they don't like seeing the people out like this, but you're here. You got to go somewhere, don't you?
Yes, sir.
So this is his home right here.
Yes, sir.
That's his home. Now, it looked like you could. Can you use one of those comforters? We might have one on the truck over here for you. Make it comfortable for you, okay?
Yes, sir. I'll walk over with you.
Sure. Let's see if we can find you a comforter and get you set up over here. And there's just a lot of people in need, and we're going to take care of this gentleman. Get it. Go right over to that truck and tell him I sent you over there, okay?
Yes, sir.
And we'll take care of him. And, folks, again, we ask you to keep us in your prayers. We're going to load up here in a minute, take off to the next place. We've got a lot of places that we got to, and we really need your prayers at this particular moment. I thank God for those that give us tents. Praise God. Somebody gave us this family combo tent. I got a family that can't get into shelter anywhere. Their van has been stolen from them. They're facing tremendous needs right now. And so we're going to get a tent set up for them here. They just can't seem to get in anywhere else. And so we've got a family here that's just don't have anywhere to go. And we're having a lot of those cases right now. Women calling us, families calling us. You listen to the radio, you listen to TV, and the mayor's saying she's putting them behind hotels. We try to figure out, how do you get them in the hotel then? They never can't get in there. How do you get them in, up in the new shelter you open? You can't figure out how to get it in there. So all I know is that the people are here hurting, and they're really in need, and so we're trying to get them right now out here and just trying to set them up. Mark, you want to tell the family to come over, and we'll get them set up here in this tent. And we have a lot of people over here getting help all the way around us here. We got a lot of other places to go, as I indicated. So we're trying to, every time I'm ready to move to a new one camp, somebody else comes along and says, hey, we really need some help right now. So what we do is we're trying to help them get that help. And I'm asking all of you to continue to support New Life Evangelistic Center. The needs are critical at this hour. We need a lot of people donating. We right now, just a financial miracle. And with God, all things are possible. And I ask all of you to just continue to just let God's light and love shine in you and through you. Is this the lady that has a family here, Mark? How are you?
No.
Okay. Well, folks, you have a tent here?
Right there.
You have a tent?
Yes.
Where's your tent at?
My tent's right over there.
How'd you ever end up out here in a tent?
Well, my landlord ended up getting his trailer court condemned because he was not fixing the septic, and the septic started leaking into the well water, and my kids started getting sick and missing school. So the school came
out
in the Lake of the Ozarks.
Way down the lake, and you couldn't find anything down there at all?
There's no homeless shelters down there. There's no nothing. All the way, I mean, we come all the way from St. Francis County.
So you did find a tent right now?
Yep.
A tent. All right.
Yeah, we have our own personal one, but it's getting kind of old. But they're supposed to be getting some new ones for us.
I gave them some new ones today, okay?
So okay.
You can ask them that, okay?
Okay.
God bless you. Here's this lady. Ma'am, you and your children need this tent?
Yes, we do.
All right, we're going to get you try to set up out here. And I think some of these men are going to help you get this put up here, okay?
Yes, sir. Truck got stolen from down here after you helped us. It's messed up. It won't start. It won't do nothing. Police just showed us where it is, and I just got it towed to the house that y'all came and bought the food to. We can't do nothing in the truck. We're outside the truck now.
So now you're moving into this tent.
Okay. If you can, I mean, right. We got kids. I got little kids, and they said it was a child molester up here, so.
Well, then this is a temporary thing. Then
exactly.
Until we get you into it. You know, but I hear the city say there's motels, but you're still here, okay? So let's just really, I think we've got some good security that guys are going to help protect you from those things, too. There's all those people out here right
yes,
here,
sir.
Okay? So tell everybody your first name.
My name is Shanae.
Father, I come to you with Shanae, and I'm asking you right now just to divinely intervene. Help Shanae now, Lord. And Lord, we're just asking that you'd get her into a permanent home and use this tent for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
You got someone to help you set it up here?
Yes, sir. Guys?
All right. Well, I'll get it set up.
Thank you.
Come back around and see your new tent.
Okay. Thank you. Thank
God
you.
God bless you. All right. Okay, folks. Well, like I said earlier, we're going to try to get to the next camps, but we keep running in one case after another. So we need all of you to really help you. Hey, children, your mama's got the tent, so go to work. You can get it up. I think these guys here, there's a tent man over there that'll help you put it up. And we'll try to get you set up. And folks, please continue to pray for us now. We've got a bunch of stops, a lot of people in need, so continue to keep praying at this hour.
I can show you how culinary gifted I am.
Okay, so yeah. We're going to have some barbecue here. We brought you some chicken.
Yes, sir.
We brought you some cookies.
Yes, sir. I'm very
How are you today, sir? Any particular needs you're facing?
Need propane.
Propane? All right. I'll mention that to Ray, days that I'm not here. What do you need the propane for?
My lantern.
Your lantern? All right.
Got a Coleman lantern with two mantles.
Okay.
So I can see at night.
All right.
Cheaper than batteries.
I got cookies over here for you. We got chicken. They're going to have chicken. I'm going to have some sandwiches. Okay.
Some juice?
Yeah. Got juice over here. Juice cups. Toilet paper. Juice cups. Toilet paper. A lot of people out here. It looks like there's more and more people coming out here all the time. Basic supplies they need. So what I need you to do is, if you need supplies, get a list together on Sunday mornings when I come around.
Yes, sir.
And then I do shopping usually outstate. There's too many lines in St. Louis.
Yes, sir.
When I go out to Springfield to help the homeless out there, and then bring some items back to you, okay?
And I thank you so much for helping us out. God bless you, Rev.
What's your first name again?
I'm Rudy. Rudy Boykins. Yes, sir. How y'all doing? God bless you. God is good. All the time.
For everybody that need it, and they're trying to survive here. A lot of people in need. How are you doing today, brother? Anything special you need?
I'm good, man. Thank you.
How are
much.
You? Well, God bless you.
Thank you. You too.
How long you been out here?
I've been homeless for about 3 years. Yep.
If we can do anything to help you get into one of our residential training programs, you're sure welcome.
I appreciate that, man. Thank you for the offer.
Pastor Ray, when he comes around.
Okay.
And we've already got one guy that's coming out tomorrow. It's in the big orange tent over there. It's Smitty from a vacant building. So I just want you to know we're thinking about you.
All right, man. Thank you very much.
God bless you, man.
You too.
Have a great day.
You too.
All right. We're getting all our supplies out. Here's... We just brought you some ice here, okay? And you still got stuff in the truck back over here. Let's see what else we got in the truck over here. David, what else we got here in the truck? Oh, here, David. They may want these peanut butter sandwiches. Let's see how many in one there is. Okay, there you go. Want peanut butter sandwiches. Oh, also we got... Oh, cereal cups here. All kinds of cereal cups for the people. I like that. Breakfast items. Okay. Here you go. Did everybody get their cereal cups?
Thanks. I'm not bringing no cereal.
Okay, I'll see if the rest of them around here. There you go. Yes, jump starts. Okay.
These are yours.
All right. Yes. So we go around to the different camps. We see a lot of people that are in need out here, trying to help them, seeing what the needs are. See, I've got some sheets, blankets left over here. I got to do an inventory.
Somewhere.
Some what?
Milk.
Okay, I think I'd. Let's see, we got milk. That's sandwiches. All right, we're going through supplies pretty quick here. And, all right, if they need any more sandwiches, we got those.
We've got plenty.
Okay, and we'll see, we'll go to the next place. Is that enough chicken for him?
Yeah.
All righty, well, I guess we'll go off to the next place then, and Lord bless you guys. Keep the faith. Let's continue to keep. Well, I just want you to know that we're out here thinking of you all.
Yeah, and I always tell people that Brev is still out here, you know, on the grind, even though they closed the shelter. And I'm praying for you every day, whatever happens. I'd love to see you have a new facility for to help my people.
We're going to do what we can. Just let us open up during the day so we can get them a shower.
Yeah, most certainly. That'd be great. I like to stay clean, too. I might come do an old celebrity shower or something, you know. Bring my good shower soap.
All right. Got your cot?
1411 Locust.
Yes, let's get it open, folks. We can do it.
Yes,
we can do it. Let's head on to the next campsite. Here, take these so we can help you, okay?
Thank
we're
you.
We're just doing it because we know God's bigger than the government, right?
I'm mad at you.
Why is that?
You know the truth, at least.
All right. Well, look, we want you to know that Jesus loves you and we care about you. That's why we're out here. It's hot. It's hard work. But there's people care about you. Can you use some more fruit cups?
Huh?
How many more of these can you use?
No. Give the rest to the pregnant lady.
All right, I'll take...
Go to the pregnant lady.
All righty, we'll go on up here to the camp.
Yeah.
Ready?
That pregnant lady.
Now, do you need a blanket or anything?
Are
you
okay? I'm good.
All right, well, God bless you.
I
want everybody
you.
Praying for you.
I'm so mad at you.
All right, we'll keep praying for
you. Another thing, is there any government funding about Greyhound tickets?
Not that I know of. Where do you want to go?
I'm going back to Utah.
Do you really?
Either Utah or Las Vegas, Nevada.
All right, when Pastor Ray comes through, as he does, talk to him about it, okay? Let's see what we can do. All right?
Thank you.
Bless you. Bye-bye, sister.
Thank you, Blake. I'm mad at you.
Oh, you keep praying for us now. I don't handle any government funding, so I don't have any power with the government. Just out here trying to do God's work. Thank God for those of you that are praying for us here. That's where that lady lives, man. Tent. Awaiting the fulfillment of a promise. And that's what it seems like, Mark. They promise all this stuff, but they don't come through with it, do they?
They never come through with it, and they promise things, they never come through, and leave you in a worse position than you were before.
That's where they're at. So we're heading down to the riverfront here. Got the river right beside us here. Trying to help as many people as we can. This is a tough time, coronavirus out here. People can't get into a place. We've already been to two camps. This is our third one. Then after this, we've got to see if we can find the people sleeping behind the bus station that we promised some clothes to. And some people in vacant buildings, so we still got a bunch of work. It's hard work, but hey, it's what Jesus told us to do, didn't he?
Yes, he did. To the least of these, he said, you do it unto him.
Amen. Beautiful scenery out here. Look at this riverfront out here. I got right beside the river, but you got to keep your eyes on the Lord and let his love just flow through you like the flow of the river. Well, we got a bunch of people up here right now. The numbers just keep growing and growing and growing. So we're up here trying to feed them. We had a man just come from here today. I met him out in New Bloomfield when I was in the prayer meeting this morning, Smitty.
Okay.
So, actually, Smitty was from the other place. He had the red tent at their last camp out, so we're at. Okay, how you doing? I got a cooler here with some ice in it, and I also got some fruit cups, sandwiches. Anybody want to barbecue some chicken? If you need anything, let me know. I'm going to walk through the camp, and anybody need something? David's got the chicken.
Put the chicken on ice.
Is he? Does he have ice over there? He does. Okay. I got some sandwiches here, David. So, David, what do you think of all this?
Well, I think what we're doing is very beneficial for all these people out here. They get a little from everybody, so hopefully with all the combined efforts, it makes it a little more comfortable for them.
Right. We also try to find out exactly what they need so that we can fill their order. That's what we've been doing the last few days. They've been telling us things they hadn't been getting. So we try to do it. And people, this whole camp out here. Somebody finally got an umbrella, look like. And we'll go down here and see a lot of them are out. They come back at night and find out who's all out here. How are you today? Got you some ice, got you some chicken. Fruit cups in here, sandwiches in here. So anybody's hungry, be sure they get fed, okay? I guess we'll set this down over here and let you share it, okay?
Okay, very good. Thank you.
How you doing? Do you have enough dog food for him?
Yeah, we do right now. Yeah.
Do you? Well,
yeah.
I might mention to Ray and give him some for you. Okay?
Yeah, he likes to chew on everything but dog food, but yeah.
All right, well, look, I want to show you what we got here. So there's a bag of ice down there.
Okay.
There's sandwiches in here, keeping it cold.
Yeah.
We got some, there's beef stew here, ready to warm up right in there, okay?
All right, nice.
Cooked up some beef stew, and down at the bottom, like I said, it's ice to help keep it all cold. So see that nothing goes to waste here.
Yeah, absolutely.
Only your waste, and their waste.
Yeah, that's it.
Nothing wasted, okay?
Right, yeah.
Help feed
yeah.
the hungry, but, oh, watch it, he'll love that beef stew, I'm telling
you.
Oh,
yeah, yeah, you see that. May you look on that solar charging thing for the phone? By chance?
And that's what we're looking, but I'm also trying to take into consideration by the time I get the inverter, the controller, and seeing that the battery's kept charged on it, am I better off doing that or temporarily getting you a small generator?
That would be perfect, like a little small, quiet one, like the little...
Yeah, ice down under here.
No, over here, buddy.
No, I'm leaving this cooler with you.
This cooler, yeah.
Uh-huh. It's got sandwiches in it, it's got fruit cups in it.
How you doing?
All right, it's got everything in it. So let me see what I can do. I'm praying somebody will donate something that we can
awesome.
Actually get a small generator.
Yeah, I mean, even like one of them little small Hondas or Yamahas that are like 1,200 watt or something like that. I mean, just enough for a little bit, just for phones mainly, and a light or something, or a fan maybe or something, you know. But yeah, that'd be amazing. It would be, and they're very, very easy one.
Eat it and then put the chicken back in there.
They're really.
This is ready to eat. All you got to do is warm it up. There you go. Okay, well, here. This is ready if somebody's hungry right now, okay? All right, so a generator. Folks, somebody going to donate to us some money for a generator? I pray they do. All right, we'll try to keep this stuff cold, too. Oh, you see, there's that. And this is ready to throw on the grill. This has all been cooked, and just warm it up, okay? Great. There, he's going to get it all over everything. So, look, it's delicious. Yeah, just warm it up. Ready to go. Beef stew, our ladies cooked up, okay? Ladies that are in our training program. Oh, listen, he smells it over here. Breakfast items. So, anyway, so, yeah, let me check on that. I'm going to try to get work on that next day or two.
That'd be
bring
awesome.
A check with
that
you
would.
Here.
Yeah, and, would.
Oh, I'd love to have it Friday, you know what I mean? So,
yeah. Well, I mean, I can even pull a little water up from the river, too, just to help rinse rough things off. You know, I mean, it's just absolutely. I can run a little pump. I mean, it's a little...
I wish we could get you a small... The ideal thing is if we get you a small microhydro system. Small microhydro system.
Yeah, that would be.
You can make those out of car generators. I mean, car alternators. Alternator.
Yeah, we talked about it.
Car alternator going around and around.
There one you can make that with just cooking wood, too.
Yeah.
I learned out there, that wood-powered one.
Right. So, yeah, so I'm saying, let's see about a regular generator. That's the first step, then, actually, to try to go. Yeah, we got these fruit cups here. You guys thirsty? Cold fruit cups? Mm-hmm. Other items? Wow. So how long you been out here?
Since December, I guess. Well, actually, January, during the first beginning of the year.
And what's his name?
That is Lily.
Oh, that's a Lily. That's
Lily.
A she.
Yeah,
that's a she.
Yeah, it's
let me
Lily.
See. Like I said, I may try to get her a little food, too, okay?
Okay, yeah.
We'll see. Yeah, you're right, Lily. We'll try to
she's
get
she's very,
something.
Very smart. She is. She's honoring, but smart.
Yeah. This is home out here, right? A lot of folks living out here in there.
Yeah, there is,
right.
Yeah.
Okay, well...
Now, if she lives with us, she's homeless. Does that make her homeless, too?
I guess she does. But enjoy that beef stew. The ladies went to a lot of work cooking that all
Yes, that looks delicious. Yeah, thank you.
And
thank
you like
much.
I said, there's sandwiches in here ready to eat. Right. And then we've got some chicken here ready for you to barbecue, okay?
That's
what's your name?
Terry.
Hey, Terry, how long you been around?
Out here. About 2 years.
Have you really?
Yes, sir.
Looks like this camp's really growing, doesn't it?
Yes, sir.
Wow, they keep growing and growing. Well, God bless you. I hope you find this all helpful.
Yes, sir.
In there, okay?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. All right. Hey, do you know if anybody needs any? We got some sheets here and some blankets.
We can always put it down in that dry tent.
All right, let's go down to the dry tent then. You want to show us where that's at or show us which one it is? Okay, we got to take some of these. Hey, I was thinking about that. Who does fishing out here?
A little bit all.
You know do you? Uh-huh. What do you need?
A grill.
A what?
A grill.
A grill? You don't have a grill?
No, there ain't no barbecue grill.
I thought I brought one out. Okay. All right, so you need a grill. All right, let's see what we can do. A lot of this shopping that I do is when I go out state, like Springfield, New Bloomfield on Monday and Tuesday, and then I'm so busy here, you know, but
I was out in New
Bloomfield. Yeah, no, this is where we have a residential training program, okay? Just had guys
I went
going.
Out there, man.
What's that?
I was just there.
All right, we learned some leadership skills. Looks like you're putting them in practice out here, okay? All right, now which one's your dry tent here?
That one right there.
That's right, Terry, you were. Well, God bless you. I'm glad to see you.
See that
one? Yeah. All right, well, Terry, let me see what I can do to help you out here, okay? Yeah, so you're making home here, right, Terry? So, Terry, let's see. You need a good grill is what you need. What else do you need out here, Terry?
That'd be about it. What about them showers? Ain't there solar showers?
There's portable showers, but what would we do for water unless we're going to pull out of the river and that's a little muddy, okay?
Or a porta potty.
You don't have that, do you?
Or a hand washing machine. You know all these other campsites they got one somehow.
The city just kind of avoided you guys altogether, right?
Yep. All right. That's pretty much what they do with all homeless people, ain't it?
Hand washing. All right, anybody out here want to help these folks? They're telling you what they need. They can use a grill out here. A hand washing station. And Mark, you got that show Terry, which is your dry tent right here?
Yeah, I'll say.
Okay. Porta potty. And we're out here trying to help them. Terry. All right, Terry, let me see what we can do. I talked to him about a little generator to try to...
A little baby grill, you know, like one of the baby ones.
Yeah, yeah.
They're probably like $15 at dollar store.
$19.95, okay. I brought one a couple of days ago out here, but I think somebody else used it. Let's see what we can get for you, okay?
Yes, sir.
I see you're trying hard out
here. Yeah, cleaning,
you?
Huh?
Yeah, well, I see you're trying hard.
I took all the trash out there and filled the dumpsters up.
Did you really?
Yeah, all this. I took all this trash out.
Wow.
There's still a lot over there, though.
Now, I got some bags. You got enough bags here?
Yeah, trash bags would be good.
You're back in my car. You'd have to follow me over there.
Yes, ma'am.
How you doing?
Yes,
who we got in there?
Nikki.
Hi, Nikki. God bless you, Nikki.
I don't want
to. Okay, Nikki. Well, Lord bless you. All right. You're doing fine. You're pregnant, hot. What else? Is there anything we can get for you, Nikki? Anything particular?
The one I was saying a shower for.
She'd love to have a shower, probably.
Even one of them solar showers, you know, you hang in the
tree. Diabetic. Yeah, I've got some fruit cups up here I brought in. I brought them some chicken to kick up, okay? Different sandwiches, and there's other food items up there, okay? All right, well, I think we got some juice up here, okay?
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of juice up there. I'll grab some for you.
Grab some for her. Nikki's back in the tent. Nikki's pregnant back there, is she? She's been here a while. The lady's been telling us about her.
I'm taking care of her.
Oh, that's wonderful. That's great. You guys got to help take care of one another here, don't you? How are you today? Anything you need?
No.
Well, God bless you.
Volunteer.
Well, wonderful. Good to see you. Thank you. We praise God for those that are coming down here. They're walking for a distance, coming down to help the people and try to get them some trash bags is what he said they needed here. And a lot of people, so we'll try to see what we can do to help these individuals as we're moving along here. Praise God for those that are here. So Terry, if you want to follow me back, whatever I got in my car, I'll give you, okay? All right. I will go back up to the car here and get him some stuff and see what else he needs there. I think I got some more of those breakfast cups if you think people want more of those too. If you need more of those, you can bring those back too with you, Terry. He's going to bring some more breakfast cups back. He's going to follow me to the car, okay?
Oh, okay, yeah.
See if I can get some trash bags and stuff. I think we pretty well got it. I mean, looks like a lot. So you're trying to help him out here, are you?
Yes, sir.
That's wonderful. Well, let me try to look around for more for that stuff. And see what they got, those solar showers. Like I said, most of the time...
on that video, you know, yeah, that you got out there in New Bloomfield.
Right, you watch that. And in the meantime, I guess... If I got a solar card here, though, like I said, I'd have to do the inverter, the controller, and there's so many people who need help right here. Often I'll start out with a regular gas power generator. They'll use that. They'll start using that. Then we'll start moving to the solar and the renewable energy stuff off of that.
Yeah.
So it's good. You got a touch of that to find out what the possibilities are, didn't you?
Yes, sir.
Jerry, how'd you end up homeless?
Got in a divorce with my old wife.
Wow. They got the loneliness of all that, the frustration of all that, and then on top of that, you've got... to try to just live in these things here, right? Well, we'll try to do what we can to help you every way we can. Okay, Terry?
Yes, sir. We appreciate it.
Yeah, just test.
You're a lot of help.
Well, we want to ask everybody to pray for you. So I'm here with Terry right now. Terry, let's stop a minute. Let's just have a word of prayer. Father, thank you for Terry, Lord. I know you love him. Let him know that you have not forgotten him. And I ask that you would just be with him and encourage him right now. In Jesus' name we thank you, Lord. In your name we pray, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
So I'm going to walk up here and try to get some additional supplies for Terry. Then we've got to move on to some other locations. So I'm asking all of you to keep us in your prayers here at New Life Evangelistic Center. So what do you all need?
We'll take sandwiches, water.
All right, we'll come right on up here. Let's get you taken care of.
Thank you.
Are you staying in this vacant building back here?
No, it's not a vacant building.
We're in the middle.
Oh, you're right in the middle where you're at it. Okay, well, let's see. All righty. Well, let's see what we can do here.
Thank you.
And God bless you. Help yourself. Whatever we got, you're welcome to, okay? And we thank God for all of you that have been sharing with us here. We're at the buildings. We've met homeless people here before. And this is our Facebook. And we thank God for those that have been joining us at this time and all of you that have been praying for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. And there's so many, many people that need help right now. And I thank God for all of you that have been continue to pray for New Life Evangelistic Center. Continue to support it. You've just got a little bit in on what our teams do every day in the St. Louis area. Also, they're out in Springfield doing it, trying to help as many, many people as we can. We can't do it without you. We receive no city, state, or federal dollars, no United Way dollars. You make it possible for us to be there when the people are hurting. Please continue to pray for New Life Evangelistic Center. Share with your family, your friends, your relatives that our teams are out here on a daily basis, and we couldn't do it without caring people like you. Again, it's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, the 63166, out in the middle of coronavirus, helping the homeless that have no place to go. Thank you for making all that possible.